Now we can discuss section 2.33, and section 2.3.3 is discussing the Poisson's and Laplace equation. We know few things from our this lecture, that the curl of electric field is equal to zero, and this leads us to the definition of electric field is the negative gradient of potential. And another thing that we know about the electric field is that from Gauss's law, that the divergence of electric field is equal to rho over epsilon naught. Now, putting the value of electric field from here in this equation, so we will get that the divergence of, and for E I write negative gradient of electric potential, this is equal to minus the divergence of a gradient, so del dot del and V here, and this is equal to minus del square V, while del square I call is the Laplacian. It is a del square operator, and del square is a Laplacian. It is gradient dot product with a gradient, or the divergence of a gradient, and this is equal to rho over epsilon naught. So I can write here rho over epsilon naught, and this implies that the del square V is equal to minus rho over epsilon naught, and this equation I call is the Poisson's equation. It relates the potential with the charge density. Similarly, if our observation is in a region where we don't have any charge distribution, like the charge distribution is not there in a region where we are observing the things, like for example, we are getting the electromagnetic waves, which we call the signals on our cell phone. But in this region, we don't have the charge distribution. The charge distribution or the oscillating charge is there in the tower. So we are receiving the effect of it. We are receiving the electromagnetic field here. So in such a situation, we will have rho equal to zero in the vicinity. And this implies here, putting rho equal to zero in this equation, del square V is equal to zero, and this we call is the Laplace equation. Del square, we can write that del square is the divergence of a gradient, or this is the dot product of two gradients, and we know that this is curly by curly x and x, and curly by curly y, and curly by curly z, and the same here. So it's a dot product, so this will be equal to curly square by curly x square plus curly square or partial square by partial y square and partial square by partial z squared. So this is the value, this is the expression for the Laplacian. So this tells us regarding the two equations, the Poisson's equation and the Laplace equation, and the solution of the Laplace equation is the topic of our third chapter. When we will move there, we will be solving this equation. When although it is to be noted that this equation is not fully solved here in the third chapter, we will write some results directly. If I do solve this one in the Cartesian coordinate, then the solution is a straight line equation. But when we do solve this thing in spherical polar coordinates, we get a lot of things here. Like when we solve this thing in a spherical geometry, we will have the Legendre polynomials is solution, we will have associated Legendre polynomials, we will have spherical harmonics and so on, because we will solve this equation with the separation of variable technique. And when we solve this equation in a cylindrical geometry, based on the cylindrical geometry, then we will have the Bessel functions, the associated Bessel functions, the cylindrical harmonics are the Bessel harmonics, and so on. So it depends on which geometry we are solving this differential equation. In classical electrodynamics, we have already solved this one, and the lectures are available as well in the Jackson classical electrodynamics, and almost more than 30 lectures are on this one.